Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, you know, a week ago, Leon asked a question about extending a series, and he kind of hit a nerve here because I used to do a lot of work in a forecasting department, and so I'm just going to kind of go on here more about forecasting. We have this series over here in A1 through A8, and we talked about how to use the forecast function. Today, I want to take a look at the LINEST function, the straight line function. It's an interesting function because it returns an array, and to use it, we have to select two cells that are next to each other. So in this case, cell C2 and cell D2 equal line ST and give it the known y's. These are the values in the series. That's all we need. And I have to hit Control Shift Enter. It returns two numbers for us. The first number happens to be the slope, the second number is the y-intercept. Now, I hate to drag you back through math here, but basically any straight line is defined as y is equal to mx plus b. B is the intercept, and then mx is the slope. Basically, what it says is we start out at negative 2, and every period we add 2.97. So I can create a little prediction formula over here. The prediction formula says, hey, we're going to start with this y-intercept, and I'll hit F4 to make sure that's absolute, plus the slope times the row of A1. Basically, that will extend this series as I copy it down. So the prediction here is that we're going to get numbers like 0.87, 3.84, and when we graph this, basically what we'll see is that the blue line is not necessarily straight. The blue line are the actuals. These kind of, start out sloping up a little bit faster, and the prediction, the straight line function, or the forecast function, is basically finding the straight line that has the least amount of error. So it drew a straight line between all those points, and the next point in the series is just an extension of that straight line. So if we go back and would use the forecast function, or even just drag the fill handle to ask for the next number, we're basically getting the value that lies along that straight line. So that's how the straight line function works. The LINEST function is, again, annoying because you have to be able to put it in two cells. You have to select two cells first and hit Control Shift Enter. And that assumes that we have just a single regression. Sometimes when you're doing multiple regression, you need to select a larger area. Or if we're asking for statistics like the R-squared value, you'll ask for a larger area. That's a topic for another day. I do want to briefly, though, point out that it's possible to figure out just the slope or just the y-intercept by using the index. So if I wanted to see just the slope, I could ask for equal index, the LINEST function. These are the known y's. And then which row do I want? I want the first row. Which column do I want? I want the first column. That will give me the slope. To get the y-intercept, I would take that exact same function, but ask for the second column. So you can imagine that instead of using the forecast function that we used in previous netcasts, I could build a formula here that would ask for basically the slope first, and then the y-intercept, do the math, and come up with the 26.61131. So that's yet another option if you need to figure out the next number in a series. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.